Now we're talking. Dancing. It's always been my scene. It's an art, an expression of the soul. Dancing is the channel for my passions, and soon I'll be flowing all over the ballroom. Some people take dance at a superficial level, for fun, or to impress others. But I see dance as an exercise for the mind. How people dance reveals who they really are. I dance as a flapper to show my freedom, flicking two fingers up at this horrendous patriarchal society. I'm sick of being told how to talk, how to dress, how to be. The only time I'm really me is when I can express how I feel, not how I'm told how to feel. Waltz when I'm cautious, rumba when I'm free, and when I'm with that really special someone, the Macarena. God, I just wish Bernadette would pay attention to me. I've been trying to catch her eye all evening, but she's been preoccupied with that ridiculous Eton Mets jaunty. I know. I'll show her some of my moves. Maybe in the heat of the moment she'll surrender herself to me.
This is fun, just us girls.
Isn't it just? You know, Bernadette, I've never met a girl quite like you.
Aw, shucks, you're too kind, Stephanie.
Only because I want to give you all the kindness I have to offer. I want to give you everything.
Oh, you know what? I dance with him,
but you can do so much better than him, Bernadette. You need someone who knows what you want, who understands you. I can give you that. Just let me show you. Can I get a spot over here, please? Cue the music. Make it raunchy.
I don't remember. last thing I knew, I was dancing, caught up in the heat of the moment, and then I see Stephanie and her feminine curves and the way that her hair glimmers in the low light of the ballroom. So I cop a feel.
The only reason you were here was to distract Bernadette, not to attack my aunt or molest my belief.
Your feet! Are you so arrogant that you couldn't possibly see how a woman could be immune to your charms? I don't like you, Winnie.
See, I told you.
Or you, or anyone like you.
But Stephanie, I can change.
Cat, believe me, even you can't change that much. I'm a lesbian.
A Presbyterian.
And the only one out of any of you here who has a chance is Bernadette.
I don't know whether to feel flattered or worried. I mean, the way Willy and Jaunty have treated me makes me feel like I'm beyond these immature men. But I just don't think I'm into Stephanie that way.
Stephanie, come along. We both know you just haven't found the right lad. Everyone knows sausage is better than crumpet.
You ignorant pig!
Was it something I said?
Well, this has gone spectacularly down the porcelain. Now, why do you think inviting Jaunty was a good idea? I should have known you'd cock everything up. Stephanie, wait!
Bernadette! You know that whole thing with Stephanie? You know, I didn't mean anything by it. You're the only gal for me.
I can't believe him. If he thinks he can just sidle up with a couple of excuses and be in a champ and taking me home, he's got another thing coming. No, Jaunty! Not now, not ever! Now leave me alone!
She wants me to chase her, doesn't she? Well, Jonathan Everard, Edgar Fotherington, and Tweeter, Biggie Hall can play these love games. I'm coming, love!
Can I get you anything else, madam? Another pint of whiskey, perhaps?
Make it a double.
You know, I can't believe what Willie's up to this time. That poor Stephanie girl. I'm Bernadette too. You know, he just uses people for his own gain without any thought to how they feel. Look at me, for God's sake! I'm sorry, madam. I didn't mean to offend you. It's just your nephew is...
A complete twerp? So it's not just me, then. I knew I couldn't be the only one around here to see him as the womanizing poacher he really is. You know, maybe this Servar chap isn't as bad as I previously thought.
Would you like to dance, mother?
Being doesn't mean that we can't, you know, have a bit of rumpy bumpy.
You mean lesbian? And yes, that's exactly what it means. Actually, scratch that. I wouldn't touch you with a red hot poker, even if you were the most beautiful woman to have ever walked the face of the earth. Do you know why, Willie?
Well, I guess there's something.
Oh my God! Just shut up and listen for once in your life.
Typical woman. Asking a question or waiting for an answer.
You, Winnie, because you are the most vile, cretinous, repulsive, uncultured, poorly educated, and generally dysfunctional pond scum I have ever wasted my time on!
Looks like I've almost lost this one. Time for one last attempt. If this doesn't work, nothing will.
Winnie, what on earth are you doing?
Look. I'm a female.
Goodbye, Winnie.
Don't worry, it worked. So, what can I do you for?
Basically, I'm trying to hide from Jaunty. He's chasing me. Seems to think we're in some sort of love game where I repeatedly run away screaming, and he repeatedly runs towards me making yah, yah noises. I don't know why I'm telling Willy this. He's been just as terrible to me as Jaunty. I guess that shows how desperate I am.
Don't worry, I'll help you out. No, helping her might get me back into her good books. It's not quite Stephanie's prolific novel, but a 10-page paint by numbers will do for now.
Well, I'm my love, I'm coming for you! Yeah, yeah.
I thought we'd been on the next boat to Paris with Stephanie by now.
Come on, Willie, don't be like that. Think of all the times, Willie. Remember Peru. And the long, lonely nights we spent in the Eden dorms
when... No! No need to bring that up. I think you'll be pal.
Now, what does a man have to do to get a drink around here, eh?
Nothing like in that spa in Havana, you rogue.
Ah, oh, yeah. Far sideways this
way. Bernadette, wait!
Oh, for crying out loud, I just got rid of Jaunty. I really don't want to be dealing with Stephanie right now.
Bernadette, look! I'm sorry. It wasn't right of me to throw myself at you the way that I did. And although I understand you'll never feel the same way, I'd still love to help you become an actress. I can get you work in the clubs that I dance in. You'll be a star, Bernadette.
And I won't need to get my bazoomas out?
I'm going to regret this. No, not if you don't want to.
Oh, thank you, Stephanie. I don't want to say, how will I ever repay you?
We'll think about that another time.
I'm so excited. I've got to go ring my agent. Thank you again, Stephanie. Thank you.
Ooh, a hot cross, honey. Hello. What's got your knickers in a twist?
Not this sleazy greaseball. Nothing that concerns you. Anyway, what are you doing back here? Last time I saw you, you were off to the bar, hand in hand with Willie, reminiscing about all those hard canings you used to get.
It wasn't like that. Nothing besides. Nothing like a firm piece of wood across the backside to truly discipline a lad. Made me the man I am today.
And I'm sure you and Willie are all the better for it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go and ring my boss about Bernadette, and then find Glenda to get my coat back.
Who the devil's Glenda?
Oh, there you are! Ran away before we had a chance to really get the party going, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, it seems all the Cinderellas are leaving the ball, so to speak.
Well, awful shame when the Chicka-Teachers would rather leave with one of their own than one of us lads.
Yeah.
Maybe Presbyterianism is contagious, eh? Yeah.
Thank you, Willie, for an interesting evening. But I've just got off the phone with my agent, and he says he's got to meet me right away to discuss my future success.
Your future success? Really? This world would eat you for a late brunch.
Actually, Jaunty, Bernadette's coming with me. I just got off the phone to my employer at the club, and I've got her an audition tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Really?
Isn't that just bloody dandy for you? Yeah, I really couldn't be happier. Yeah, I see how it is. Use me for my direction and leave without a tip of the hat.
Why, listen here, you little bit.
We're leaving, and I'm taking Glenda with me.
What?
That's Glenda.
I can't just take my manservant. I need him for, well, everything.
Truly, I've booked at the hotel in Paris and we'll be married within the weekend. Goodbye, Willie. Take care. Or don't, I don't drink care. Upon that bombshell, I think we'll take our leave. You've been a terrible gentleman, Willie, and an even worse host. I do hope you find yourself surrounded by a peckish lion sometime in the near future.
And that reminds me, I'm starving. Let's go find a bite to eat.
Hey, what's the gorgeous little Italian place down the road? They do the most wonderful sandwich.
Great party, Willie. Really, stellar job.
So, should we ring Barbara?
Who's Barbara?
Oh, you know Barbara.
Oh, yeah, Master Chess.